Have a good day, student. Welcome to my next lecture about commutation and concept of reactance voltage, which is the lecture 7 of electrical machine. Day by day I will upload the all videos of electrical machine. So myself Santanu Noskar, assistant professor of electrical department GKCM JIS group. My mail ID is santanu.uyt@gmail.com and also santanu.noskar_gkcem@jis group. This is my Facebook page, Being Electrified with Santanu. Okay, so let's start. So in this video we can learn what is commutation, what is ideal commutation, what is commutation period, and what is reactance voltage. Okay, so at first, what is commutation? In this figure, this is the schematic diagram of two pole lap wound generator. There are two parallel paths between the brushes, therefore each coil of the winding carries Ia/2 in this case of the total current Ia entering or leaving the armature. Okay, so this is the alternating current Ia/2. This is commutator segment, this is the brushes, and this is the flow of direct current. Now note that the current in the coil connected to a brush are either all towards the brush, positive brush, or all directed away from the brush, which is negative brush. Therefore, current in a coil will reverse as the coil passes a brush. This reversal of current as the coil passes a brush is called the commutation. So actually, the reversal of current in a coil as the coil passes the brush axis is called the commutation. Okay, when commutation take place, the coil undergoing commutation is short circuited by the brush. The brief period during which the coil remains short circuited is known as commutation period. In my next PPT, I will describe the commutation period. Commutation period is denoted by T in sub C. If the current reversal is completed by the end of commutation period, it is called ideal commutation. Okay, I will describe also the ideal commutation. If the current reversal is not completed by that time, then sparking occurs between the brush and the commutator, which result in progressive damage to both. Okay, so next is ideal commutation. There are four figure: figure 1, figure 2, figure 3, figure 4, sorry, 5 figure, and figure 5. Okay, so what is ideal commutation? Let us discuss the phenomenon of ideal commutation. Example, coil has no inductance. Okay, in one coil the armature winding shown in this previous figure, okay. Now for this purpose we consider the coil A. Okay, the coil A, the brush width is equal to the width of the commutator segment and 1 mica insulation. Suppose the total armature current is 40 ampere. So the total armature current is 40 ampere. Since there are two parallel paths, each coil carries 20 ampere. Okay, so each coil carries 20 ampere. So I'm one by one describe the all figure, figure 1, figure 2, figure 3, figure 4, figure 5. Okay, so start. In figure 1, The brass is in contact with segment 1. Just what I am telling, just you look over this picture. Now I am describing the figure 1. In figure 1, the brass is in contact with segment 1 of the commutator. The commutator segment 1 conducts a current of 40 ampere to the brass, 20 ampere from coil A and 20 ampere from adjacent coil A and 20 ampere from adjacent coil as shown in the figure. The coil A has yet to undergo the commutation. Okay, next, the figure 2. As the armature rotates, okay, the brass will make contact with segment 2 and thus short circuit the coil A as shown in the figure 2. There are now two parallel paths into the brasses. As long as the short circuit of coil A exists, figure 2 shows the instant when the brass is 1/4 on segment 2 and 3/4 on segment 1. Okay. For this condition, the resistance of the path through segment 2 is 3 times the resistance of the path through segment 1. Okay. Then the brass again conducts a current of 40 ampere, 30 ampere through segment 1, 30 ampere through segment 1 and 10 ampere through segment 2. Note that current in coil A, the coil undergoing commutation, is reduced from 20 to 10 ampere. Okay. Now figure 3. Figure 3 shows the instant when the brass is 1/2 on segment 2 and 1/2 on segment 1. The brass again conducts 40 ampere, 20 ampere through segment 1 and 20 ampere through segment 2. Okay, look over the picture. 20 ampere segment 1, 20 ampere segment 2. Now the resistance of the two parallel paths are equal. Okay, so resistance are equal. Note that no current in coil A. So here is no current, zero current. Now figure 4. Figure 4 shows the instant the brass is 3/4 on segment 2 and 1/4 on segment 1. The brass conducts a current of 40 ampere, 30 ampere through segment 1, 30 ampere through segment 1 and 30 ampere through segment 2 and 10 ampere through segment 1. Note that current in coil A is 10 ampere but in the reverse direction. Okay. To that, before the start commutation. So this is from figure 4. Now figure 5. Figure 5 shows the instant when the brass is contact only with segment 2. The brass again conducts 40 ampere, 20 ampere from coil A and 20 ampere from the adjacent coil to coil A. Note that now current in coil A is 20 ampere. So here 20 ampere current but in reverse direction. Thus the coil A has undergo commutation. Each coil undergo commutation in this way as it passes the brass axis. Note that during commutation, the coil under consideration remains short circuit by the brass. Okay, so this is the ideal commutation. One thing in this figure shows the current time graph for the coil A undergoing commutation. The horizontal line AB represent a constant current of 20 ampere up to the beginning of commutation. From the finish of commutation, it is represented by another horizontal line CD. This CD on the opposite of the zero line and the same distance from AB. The current has exactly reversed minus 20. The way in which current changes from B to C depends upon the condition under which the coil undergoes commutation. If the current changes at uniform rate, like BC straight line, then it is called ideal commutation. Okay, as shown in this figure. Under such condition, no sparking will take place between the brass and the commutator. So, what now I will discuss what is the commutation period. Commutation period is TC, T in sub C equals to W in sub B minus W in sub M by V. W, V is brass width in semi, WM is mica thickness in semi, and V is the peripheral speed of commutator in semi per second. Before this, one thing to say. What is reactance voltage? Reactance voltage is the coefficient of reactance voltage equals to coefficient of cell inductance into rate of change of current. Okay, from where this is come? From this, when a coil undergoes commutation, two commutator segments remain short circuited by the brass. Therefore, the time of short circuit or commutation period TC is equal to the time required by the commutator to move a distance equal to the circumferential thickness of the brass minus the thickness of one insulating strip of mica. So, WB is the brass width in semi, WM is mica thickness in semi, V is the peripheral speed of commutator in semi per second, and commutation period equals to WB minus WM by V in second. Okay, the commutation period is very small, say of the order of 1 by 500 second. Now let the current in the coil undergoing commutation change from plus I to minus I amperes during the commutation. If L is the inductance of the coil, then reactance voltage is given by ER is reactance voltage, which is equals to L into 2I by TC for linear commutation. So thank you. This is my Facebook page, Being Electrified with Shantanu, and this is my YouTube channel, Being Electrified. You can like my Facebook page and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.